Belinda Audio presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, Kev and Borax, written by Lorraine Orman and read by Stig Weems. David is being picked on by bullies. He wishes for a fairy godmother to help him out, but instead he gets Kev, a punk fairy godfather, and his troll dog, Borax. Will any of Kev's harebrained spells work? The dedication reads, "To my sons, Mark and Scott." Chapter 1. David ran through the car park. He didn't care about the cars swerving and tooting at him. As he ran, he kept his eyes on the front entrance of the shopping mall, where a little fountain splashed merrily. "Oh no," he groaned. "They're already there." Charging across the footpath, he came to a halt by the fountain, but was so puffed he couldn't speak. "You're late," Steve Coombs snapped, glaring down at him.
Sorry, David gasped. "Mrs. Taylor wanted to talk to me about my science project."
"No excuses," said Pete Everson, Steve's mate.
He was just as tall as Steve, but so skinny he looked like a scarecrow.
"Only wimps stay late to talk to teachers," growled Larry Smith, the third member of the gang.
He moved close to David, jamming him against the edge of the fountain. David tried not to breathe. Larry's breath could kill a skunk at 10 paces.
"Come on, hand it over,"
Steve said, clenching his fist.
"I don't like waiting, duckface, and I've already been waiting 10 minutes.
David took $2.50 out of his back pocket. Steve grabbed the money.
"Mark him off," he told Pete. "Paid. And double the next payment. For lateness."
"Aw,"
protested David. But he shut up when the three bullies scowled and leaned in towards him. Skinny Pete wrote in a grubby red notebook, "David Leiter, alias Duckface. Paid," he said as he wrote.
"Next payment, $5, due on Friday."
Steve, the leader of the gang, grabbed David's wrist in two big hands.
"Just to remind you not to be late again," he said, giving David a quick Chinese burn.
"Ow!"
David cried.
"Remember, Duckface, same place, same time, Friday,"
warned Larry with a parting blast of bad breath. Chapter 2. David was close to crying as he walked away from the mall. Life had become a nightmare since the three bullies stopped him on the way home from school a month ago. They'd pinched and punched him, tipped the contents of his backpack in the gutter, and stolen his pencil case. Then they told him they wanted his pocket money paid over twice a week or he'd get more of the same. For a month, David had been feeling angry and scared and ashamed all at the same time. To make things worse, the bullies started calling him Duckface. He knew his nose was big, but surely it wasn't that big. He kept on worrying about it, peering at himself in mirrors and putting his hand over his nose when he was talking to people. This wasn't a good idea, because no one could hear what he was saying. "I wish I had a fairy godmother," he thought, kicking at an empty...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.